Welcome back from that break. This is Family Unscripted here on Urban TV. Thank you very much for choosing us this lovely Sunday afternoon. And we are looking at family planning. Is it safe? Is it important? We're looking at different ways. And I have with me Annette, who is a mother, but she also works with the Bukede paper. I have a gynecologist here. I'm trying to understand why there are many questions over and over again over the same things. Family planning, I used this happened. I used the other one. I am tired. I have a friend who actually walked up to me and said, "Nkoye, I'm no longer going to do family planning, come what may." And I'm thinking, you have been okay. And she's like, no, I have been struggling. Why? What causes all this?
As I said earlier, generally women don't get enough information. The health workers do not take enough time to look out on what would be suitable for a certain category of women, because women are not the same.
Mm.
You have to take them individually. You have to take a very good history.
Mm.
You have to rule out all the things I talked about, the risk factors, very
right.
important.
Right.
You have to look at the lifestyle. Because,
mm-hmm.
for example, if someone smokes, they won't be able to use the estrogen-based method of family planning, like the pill. Otherwise, they end up getting pregnant or they end up getting
even
a clot.
Even those who drink alcohol?
Those who drink alcohol are not actually supposed to take the hormonal methods, because generally, especially the chronic consumers, alcohol increases metabolism of these drugs, breaks them down so easily, and they can conceive on the method. So we need to put all these in perspective before we advise a couple. Unfortunately, most people rush.
Yeah, true.
Most of the time, women come with a method
in their head,
mm-hmm. of course.
And you would really struggle to change it, because they listen to a friend, a colleague, a neighbor. I would really want to advise women that if you want a method of family planning, visit a health worker who is knowledgeable,
mm-hmm.
because not every health worker
is knowledgeable. Yes.
So that they give you the right information,
they
take you through proper history taking, a very good physical examination, including taking your blood pressure, taking your weight and height, they look at your body mass index, they look at, you know, many other things to be able to tell whether you
work.
Can. Yeah. It is a lot of work.
It's
not a one-off. And then the health work will come up with a method that suits you according to your needs, your desires, and
your physical
acceptability.
Jesus Christ. I think I support Annette.
Huh?
These things are complicated. Naturally, you just chill.
Ideally, they are not supposed to be complicated.
Then what complicates them?
Of course, every method
of
family planning, apart from the natural, even the natural way is complicated. Every method of family planning has...
Not very complicated.
It has its setbacks.
Uh-huh.
Adhering to the natural method also comes with a lot of discipline.
True.
A lot of discipline.
True.
For both sides.
Yes.
And I want to tell you that men are not even not cooperative.
Some are not, I hear. Anyway.
Yes, and I've seen women on natural methods of family planning
who
end up with backup methods.
They do.
Every method has its own setbacks, but the most important thing is counseling the relatives, rather the clients, giving them as much information as possible. And giving them the right method.
Annette.
I know many women out there who use most of these other methods.
I want to ask Annette, how have you managed to discipline? Okay, I'm sorry to ask this, but
your husband.
Yes. I mean, but men are really, they need you to be understanding. Really.
Yes.
But how have you managed?
I think first thing, anyway, when we had just met,
when
I had just had my first child, I tried pills. I didn't go to a proper medical work, I think. I just went to a clinic. There was a friend of mine. I said, why not pill? Let me try pills. I tried them for a week. I couldn't manage. The headache was just killing me. So I told him, but these things, he said, why don't you leave it? We can count. So I went to a gynecologist. He told us how to count. actually told me every month you begin afresh. Every month you count. It's not like between 14th and 15th, I'm okay. No. Every month has a different dates. Because periods keep on shifting. So he sat us down, told us how to count. So the calendar is in the bedroom.
Wow.
Red,
yes.
Then the rest. He's been cooperative anyway.
Do you still do it now?
I do it. Wow. I do it, though for the last 10 years, he's been on and off. Mm. He doesn't work from here.
Oh, okay.
So he comes once in a while. So maybe that has also helped me.
Sometimes you're like, stress.
Of course, because if you know you'll come in December, why count now?
I know, right?
Yes. So maybe it is different for me.
Yeah.
Because he's not been around for 10 years.
That's quite
he's just come back. This year, this month.
Okay, that's lovely. That's really lovely.
I think if you sit down as a couple,
yes,
and you talk about it properly, and you all have common goals,
mm-hmm,
because the problem at times the men want more kids,
yeah,
then the woman doesn't want,
and they don't come to an agreement.
Yes, it becomes complicated. Mm. So you can't tell him we shouldn't mm-hmm, when he.
There's a common, when you talk about precautions, there's a common thing. What are they called?
Morning after?
There's pills, you know, young girls run to.
Emergency.
Emergency pills. Yes, that was the word. What is so special about them? I mean, girls, I'll take the pill. What is so interesting about them?
Emergency pill is, some people call it a morning after pill.
Mm-hmm.
Morning after sex pill.
Of course, morning after sex, yes.
You know, basically, it should be a one-off. It should be a one-off. And there are many different types on market. The common one is
Postina.
The P2.
Hey,
call it
P2.
You walk to the pharmacy and say P2. That's an emergency pill.
Wow.
But the whole idea is that you went into trouble. You didn't plan.
Allegedly,
yes. You know, sometimes when you ask how many people have planned children, you might find that most of us are unwanted. We're unwanted.
Yeah.
But anyway, the issue is there should be a plan for every woman. You shouldn't keep falling into trouble. I've kept telling women that if you find yourself wanting or using morning after pill or emergency pill many times in a month, then it is an indication that you need a permanent method of family
planning.
Okay, so you shouldn't keep running to a pill all the time because it comes with a bit of complications. A morning after pill has a high level of hormone, which is supposed to work immediately to suppress any process of ovulation in a woman's body. But because it has high levels of progesterone, then it will change the cycle. Women will bleed excessively.
Do you get cases of people who have taken these pills over and over and now they have issues?
Many young women in adolescence.
It's common there.
They have devoted to using the pill as a method of family planning, and that's wrong. I want to advise them that that's wrong.
Absolutely.
It's an addiction. Mm. It gives some cover of safety.
But it
doesn't work that way because it compromises a woman's cycle. It works on the ovary and inhibits it, and then you find periods irregular. It doesn't cause infertility, but certainly it causes menstrual problems.
Yeah.
So I would advise women that if you feel you're running to the morning after pill many times, more often than
today,
then get a method of family planning.
Thank you now that you mentioned that. What are those common methods that are available for women that most women run away from? And how do I know this is good for me? For example, when you look at me, for example, which one is good for me?
None.
Of course, we need to go through a series of issues to zero down to what method.
Yeah.
And as I said earlier, family planning is a plan.
Mm.
I don't know your plan. Maybe you intend to have...
Scary.
It's scary.
Yeah.
That means you you won't have children for the next 10 years.
No.
Or you won't have children at all.
So the issue
is you need to have a plan. Mm-hmm. Then we follow your plan.
Okay.
And these methods, generally, I want to say that most of the methods mm-hmm. are generally safe if used correctly mm-hmm. and properly.
When you say used, I've asked you the types, but
I'm going to tell you about the types.
Probably you will.
Yes.
Now, let me focus on this one that has been bugging me, and the reason why I actually came up with this topic. A friend of mine has been using a coil. Mm. I don't know, does it have another name?
IUD.
IUD, yes. So she says it, in actually, two friends, it keeps moving. They put it, but somehow it moves, and the other one told me the doctor could not find it. I saw on Facebook, the other one is like, she was actually writing, it moved up and moved up to the back. I'm thinking, how is that even possible? So they keep moving. And it has affected her, and she says, I don't know what happened. I think I got tired. I was in constant pain, so we found a way of removing it. Now, she was telling me, please do not use any family planning methods. And I'm thinking, don't worry, I'm not even interested. So the thing is, what is the problem with these things?
Incidentally, it's perhaps they used the wrong choice, they didn't get enough information, or they went to the wrong health worker. Generally, the methods common on market, or common in Uganda, are the short-term methods, and these are the pills, what we call the COCs.
Okay.
They have a combination of estrogen and progesterone. A pill is very effective. 99% effective in controlling pregnancy. It has a few side effects are related to the estrogen in them, and basically most of them are to do with the headaches. Yes, but when women use them, they tend to stabilize over time. And you need to know which is good, because for us we know which pill is better than the other, depending on the concentration of the hormones in them. That's why you need a good health worker who knows what to do. And then you have the injector plan.
The one they
inject every 3 months.
Inject.
Yes, that is very common, and it's a women's preference. I don't know why. But injector plan is a very traditional method, old dated. The drug in injector plan is a very old type of progesterone, which has quite a number of side effects.
Okay, I want you to hold it there. I'm sorry to cut you short. My producer says we take a break. When we return, he will still tell us more about these family planning methods. And later, I want to know the myths. He says there are lots of myths surrounding these things. But we see these things happening. He will explain. We'll be back.